Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and welcome to our complete After Effects Beginners course. We're gonna be going through the program and getting you up to speed so that you can start using it on your own. So let's jump into it. After Effects can seem like a really intimidating program if you've never actually used it before, but this doesn't have to be the case. We're gonna try to get you up to speed and using After Effects on your own in under 1 hour. We've broken up this course into 8 videos so that if you need to go back and do a refresher on a particular subject, you can easily do that. As Premiere Pro is becoming a more and more powerful program itself, the chances that you can actually complete an entire video project inside Premiere alone is becoming way more frequent. But still, every so often, you're gonna come across projects in which you need a lot more flexibility and precision to get a particular scene done. This is usually where After Effects comes into play. The way I would go about describing it is that one tool is more like a scalpel, whereas the other one is more like a saw. Both are designed to cut things, but you're gonna have a lot of trouble cutting down a tree with a scalpel, and you probably don't wanna do an operation with a saw. Each tool has its specific purpose. After Effects is really great at compositing elements into a scene, as well as doing really professional graphic design work. It has a whole host of other applications as well, but the basic principle is that it's a very powerful tool, and the better you understand it, the more likely you'll be able to use it effectively in a future video project. Are you excited? Let's jump right into our first After Effects tutorial in this course, learning the interface.
So here we are on our computer's desktop, and the first thing that we want to do is actually update After Effects so that it's running on the most current version. To do this, go to your Creative Cloud account and make sure that there's no new updates available for After Effects. If there is, it's always worth keeping up to date just in order to make sure that you don't run into any problems that the new update has already solved. Now that you're up to date, let's open up After Effects. What you should be greeted with is the start screen, where you can open up any previous projects that you've been working on, or start a new one. We're going to be starting a new one of our own, so click New Project, and you're off and running. From here, you're greeted with the After Effects interface, which, if you've used Premiere Pro before, should be at least a little bit familiar. But it might be overwhelming if you don't know what everything does, and where it's located. So let's start off by looking at each of these panels. Up here we have the project window. This is where we keep all of our footage that we're working with, as well as any compositions that those clips are in. We'll get into compositions a little bit more later on, but for now, think of compositions like a sequence in Premiere Pro, a file that represents a grouping of media that you're working on. So to start with, let's bring in some clips so that we can see what a working project file looks like. Either double-click on the project window to choose clips, or just drag and drop them in from your computer. Great, now let's take a look at the composition monitor. This is where you'll be able to view your work much like the source monitor and project monitor in Premiere Pro. Right now it doesn't show anything because our timeline is empty, but let's quickly double click one of our pieces of footage and we can see that it shows us our footage. But you can see that it creates this new little tab here to view under. It says footage because we're viewing the individual piece of footage instead of what's on our timeline. There's a couple things here that you need to know. First is the size of your window. You can easily change this by scrolling up or down with your mouse wheel or touchpad to make your viewer bigger or smaller. Or you can use a specific percentage amount in the bottom left tab here. Choosing the fit option will automatically let After Effects decide the best size for your viewer. So for right now, let's go back to our composition by hitting the composition tab to go back. So right now our composition window is showing us that we can either create a brand new composition or create a new one using a specific piece of footage as a starting point. I'm just going to create a new one by dragging our footage from the project window to the composition window. And there we go, our footage is now on our timeline. And as you can probably tell, our timeline is the box down here. It's basically functionally very similar to the one that's in Premiere Pro. Grab the playhead and you can see what's in your composition. And time passes as normal from left to right. And like you might imagine, pressing the space bar will let you play your clips in real time. And over here we have the resolution tab. Right now it's set to full resolution, but if you're having trouble playing back your footage or having trouble playing back a composition later on, you can actually decrease the quality here so that the playback runs smoother. This won't change the quality of your overall project and when you finally export it, it'll just change how you view it in the moment. So if we drop it down to half, or even 1/4, it'll be easier for After Effects to let us view our project in real time. But it's important to point out here that After Effects will always try to play your footage back in real time, but depending on your project, how elaborate it is, and the resolution you're trying to play back at, it may not actually succeed, and you may have to render it in order to actually view your project back in real time. And finally, this last panel here is our miscellaneous panel, which has a variety of tabs that we can use to impact our composition. Things like information about our footage, audio layouts, effects and presets, etc. And we'll get more into how to use all of these features in the next few videos. But for right now, we're just going to quickly go over two last sections. Here at the top left, you should see a variety of tools that you can use. Every time you click on a different tool, your mouse will take on a different function to work with your project. You have a simple selection tool, a hand tool for moving things around, a zoom tool, a rectangle tool, and a type tool, just to name a few. Later on, we'll go into some of these in great detail, but for right now, if you want to use a specific tool, you'll locate it up here, and if you hold your mouse over a particular one, you'll get its name and its shortcut key, so that you can access it really quickly. And finally, we have our workspace tabs over here at the far right. This is where you can choose from a different selection of ways that all these boxes can be organized. So you can see that the blue highlight here tells us that we're in the default setting, but we can also choose others like standard, minimal, and paint just to get a couple different layouts for different purposes. But we're going to stay with the default for now. But it's important to remember that even in the default, you can move around all these boxes to make your project layout your own. Make areas bigger or smaller by dragging the divides between each, or grab an entire tab and move it to a different location. Play around with these so that you can get comfortable knowing how to work with your interface. But don't worry about messing anything up, because if you do what I just did and move things around to a point where you say, "Ew, that looks really gross," you can really easily set it back to normal by going to Window, Workspaces, and Reset Default to Saved Layout. Now it's back to normal. Easy as that. And guys, that's just been a quick overview of the layout in After Effects. But before we move on to the next video, let's go ahead and hit Control or Command S, or go to File, Save As, and save your project so that you don't lose any work. Let's make sure to place it somewhere that we can find it pretty easily. Putting it in its own folder is a really good idea. And title it something that will let us know instantly which project it is that we're looking at. Guys, I hope that helps you start feeling a little bit more comfortable about working inside of After Effects. In the next video, we're going to go in detail about how to work with video layers and compositions. I'll see you in the next video.